Inside Tess's body is a rare and deadly disease, but it is not yet visible.
Huntington's disease is a hereditary and fatal brain disorder. There is no cure nor any disease-modifying therapies to offer to the individuals that are affected by the disease.
It is between the ages of 30 and 50 that it usually shows itself through sudden twitching in the fingers and toes. Tess's doctor is Åsa Petersén, and she wants to help Tess and everyone else affected by the disease.
Our aim with our research is to identify the earliest changes in the brain in Huntington's disease, and then to target those with a molecular tool to stop the disease progression and ultimately identify a cure.
Huntington's disease is caused by a single gene. In it, a small piece of DNA has mistakenly begun to be copied far too many times. The altered gene then, in turn, produces a damaged version of the Huntington protein. It forms in all cells of the body, but only causes damage in the brain. There, it kills nerve cells in the motor center of the brain, the part of the brain that regulates our movements. The disease escalates over time, and at the end, the symptoms can resemble dementia. From the point of diagnosis, the patient usually has 15 to 20 years left to live.
My pappa was 55 when he fick diagnosen Huntington's sjukdom.
In connection with the father's diagnosis, Tess and her siblings were told that there was a 50% risk that they too carried the disease. They tested themselves, and the day Tess got her results, she will never forget.
Då vet jag ju att jag ska gå in till min pappa och säga att att man är positiv liksom. Och det är ju mer för att jag vet att han klart blir liksom otroligt ledsen. Att det går i arv.
Tess's brothers also got the same test results. They all carry Huntington's disease.
Hej Tess, välkommen.
Hej Åsa. Hej.
Hej. Jag tänkte vi kunde börja prata om hur det har varit den senaste tiden.
Jag försöker att hålla mig så aktiv jag kan.
The meetings that we have at the Huntington Clinic can sometimes be very difficult. But I take that despair and frustration with me to the research laboratory and share it with the research team. And that drives us to work even harder.
Du kunna ta en titt?
Absolut.
Åsa Petersén and her team have made completely new discoveries about Huntington's disease. They have seen that the involuntary movements at the onset of the disease are not at all the first symptoms. Both cognitive and psychiatric symptoms can occur up to 15 years before that. The faulty Huntington protein appears to affect, in addition to the neurons in the motor center, one of the brain's emotional centers as well, the hypothalamus. This in turn seems to lead to poor sleep, personality changes, anxiety, apathy, and sudden outbursts.
Från början så var det ju mest det här 0-100 utbrotten. Du kan inte hantera dem för att det är så svart och just där och då så vill du bara vara elak.
There are medications that can help with the early symptoms such as anxiety or anger.
Mina humörsvängningar och irritabiliteten och så, det är mycket bättre under kontroll.
But so far, nothing can slow down or cure the disease. Nerve cells in the brain continue to die. But Åsa Petersén has discovered what kind of nerve cells are affected. The disease kills nerve cells that produce the hormones orexin, also called hypocretin, and oxytocin. Orexin affects our motivation and sleep, while oxytocin reduces stress and depression. And in experiments, the researchers have seen that mice with Huntington's that have depression-like behavior get rid of it if they are given oxytocin.
Jag har vetat ända sedan jag träffade Åsa att det finns så mycket som händer hela tiden. Dock har jag ju inte själv liksom levt för det här att det ska komma ett bot till mig. Utan jag tänker att nu jobbar vi på, nu kan de jobba på oss och liksom är det till nästa generation.
Based on the intense research that's being conducted in many laboratories around the world, including in pharmaceutical companies, I believe that there will be some kind of a disease-modifying therapy for Huntington's disease within 15-20 years.